Sorry, actually this is my second video. I was in a different mode. So okay, that's the cantonment. Then we had this bungalow type of thing. The bungalow type of thing was a new feature of the housing system. Scholars point out that its origin can be traced to synthesis of two cultures. That detached Bengali house nestled in a compound and the suburban English villa. The bungalow was a unique architectural feature of the Raj, British Raj. Being the British Empire in India, the bungalow represented the power of its residents. Bungalow, oh my God, they have got a bungalow. These are top class people. The wealthy British residents of the bungalow were separated from outsiders by the walled compound. The spacious gardens indicated rank and status. The servant lived in separate quarters within the compound. In the cities, the Indian elite, consisting of wealthy merchants, civil servants, and industrialists, also lived in sprawling bungalows. The poorer section lived in tenants with cramped and congested rooms, poor sanitation, proximity to open drains. This was the life. This is how the British happened to torture. This was the urban part. The introduction I gave you, the urban part I gave you. Now we are going to do the towns and cities. Administration of the towns and cities. The medieval towns were divided into thanas, wards were further subdivided into mohallas or neighborhoods. The kotwal or town magistrate, thanedars, mohalladars and darogas, policemen, were responsible for law and order, local administration. I'm just giving you a brief about it. In 1793, the Cornwallis Code ended the local government systems put in place by the earlier rulers. District collector became to be known as the most important of the district administration, the district collector. Urban areas were brought under the control of the municipality. It was put in charge of public health, sanitation and roadworks, PWD. 1687, the Madras Municipal Corporation was set up. It is the oldest corporation of India. The district collector was also put in charge of the Diwani Adalat. The erstwhile authority held by the Qazis was now taken away. Now what did the British do? The codification of law took place with equality before the law becoming the abiding principle. They started putting in laws. 1850, municipalities were introduced for the whole British of India. The Municipal Improvement Act 1864 empowered the Lieutenant Governor to appoint municipal commissioners of any town. The chairman of the municipality was the district magistrate. He was assisted by the commissioners who were selected from among Indian and British officers. Tax on roads, markets and ferries were the main source of revenue. The police. As per the Police Act of 1861, a modern police force was created in India. It was headed by the Inspector General of Police, IG, which we still have. He was in charge of the functioning of the entire department. He was assisted by the Deputy Inspector General and other officers. The police force at the local level consisted, which is still there, the inspector, the head constable and the sergeant and the constables. The administration of the jails was conducted as per the new jail code. Transport and communication. Lord Dalhousie set up Public Department Works, PWD, Public Works Department. It was in charge of building and repairing roads, bridges and canals. It undertook the repair of the Grand Trunk Road between Calcutta and Peshawar, Pakistan. Many such projects were undertaken over the years. That road was Grand Trunk Road, was built by Sher Shah Suri. Railways. In the mid-19th century, Lord Dalhousie introduced railways in India. The first track operated from Bombay to Thane in 1853. From Bombay to Thane, close by. In 1880, the network extended about 14,000 kilometers, 14,500 kilometers, moving mostly inward from the three major port cities of Bombay, Madras and Calcutta. Moving inside. In 1895, India had started building its own locomotives. The railways were meant to facilitate the movement of raw materials and finished goods and thereby serve British interests. Nothing to do with the Indians. The introduction of railways had a significant impact in linking the different parts of the country. It allowed Indians to travel with ease within their country and became aware of each other's cultures. New towns developed along the new railway network. Then came in the postal and telegraph system. The introduction of the telegraph system in India was started by the inauguration of the first telegraph line between Calcutta and Agra, 1853. It led to the establishment of an efficient telegraph network. Postage stamps introduced this period. Now, today, at today's this time when I'm speaking, there is no more telegraph. The telegraph has been stopped because people are using emails and SMS. Now, case study of Delhi. What happened in Delhi? After the revolt in 1857, the Indian Empire came under the direct rule of the British Crown. In 1911, the capital of India was shifted from Calcutta to Delhi. A team of British architects led by Edward Lutyens and Herbert Baker designed the new political and administrative area known as New Delhi. We had Old Delhi, we still have Old Delhi and we have New Delhi. Old Delhi is total the Mughal Empire. Then we came into New Delhi with these great architects. They incorporated international and local architectural concepts to create a style that fused styles from both the East and the West. New Delhi was a symbol of the imperial power of the British. At its heart was the Viceregal Lodge, which is still there, home of the Viceroy. After independence, this became to be known as the Rashtrapati Bhavan, President's House. It represents a fusion of Hindu, Islamic and European architecture. It has a huge staff to take care of the extensive grounds and gardens and the lavish residence. President lives like a king. The council chamber, now which is called the Parliament House, North Block and South Block, India Gate and Connaught Place, were some of the imposing structures built during the colonial period which last to this day. India Gate is there, Parliament House is there, the North Block is there, the South Block is there, Connaught Place is one of the best places of Delhi. I love Connaught Place in Delhi. It's a happening place, Connaught Place. Then we have the, the underground market. I'm forgetting the name of the underground market. Just next to, it's under Connaught Place. The Kingsway, known as the Rajpath. Rajpath connected India Gate to the Rashtrapati Bhavan. This road is called the Rajpath. Lutyens planned New Delhi to have wide tree-lined avenues in contrast with the narrow lanes of the old city of Shah Jahanabad, Old Delhi. New Delhi is much more broader and much more favorable to travel around. Posh area. This is the basic things I told you. Okay, so you must read through go through it, and this chapter you'll do it yourself. You have to read through yourself and understand. I have given you everything which was there. 65, right? If it's 65, everything is there. Delhi in the 19th century, what happened, the old Delhi, the Delhi after partition, that's what I told you everything. So please read and take care, and do it in the next class. I'll come and give, I'll do the reading for you, okay? So please do take care of yourselves and enjoy your life and respect your parents. Bye bye. God bless.